Okay, so adding memcache to ASCII-chan gave us two new properties that are really nice. One is that our cache survives restarts. Before, when we were using that dictionary cache, if we updated our code, either locally or in production, our cache gets cleared. That's not a good quality. Or if, you know, in production, if Google for some reason moves us to a different machine or something like that, which can happen, our cache would get cleared, which is also, you know, it's just not a good property, especially if you have a lot of traffic. And our app is now stateless, which is the key to scaling. What stateless means is our app, between any two requests, stores no state. And that means a number of properties come from this. You know, there's no state between requests, which means our apps are now interchangeable, which means we can have multiple apps without any drama. You know, we have our load balancer, we have our memcached, and in between those two pieces of technology are as many app servers as we need. You know, adding more app servers is easy. Likewise, removing an app server is also easy and not painful. And it means our apps can be scaled independently of our cache and our database. So we've got our app servers, you know, we've got our database, and you know, we've got our cache. And if we find ourselves needing more app servers, we can add one. Let's add our load balancer in here for good measure. And so now we've got all these pieces. If we need another app server, we add one. If we need another memcache, we add one. Having lots of caches means we won't have to scale our database quite so fast. But if we need more databases, we talked about this in Unit 3. You know, we can go with replication or we can go with sharding. But now you're starting to see the kind of the bigger picture of how a website might grow. If you're really data heavy, you have lots of databases and maybe lots of caches. You know, if your database is very read heavy, but it's not actually a lot of data, you'd have more caches. If your application is very computationally intensive, maybe you have lots of app servers and you don't need so much database support or not so much cache support. But what we want to do is we want to make sure that all of these different pieces can grow independently. And that's kind of what scaling is all about, is putting yourself in a position so that when your app is constrained in different ways, you can grow each part kind of independent of the others. And now that our app is stateless, it's really easy to do that. And memcached helps a lot because all of the state is either stored in cookies, the DB, or memcached, but not the apps. And that's really handy.